Hey, it's Paul from howtoplaybass.com. Today's tutorial, we're going to look at how to play Locked Out of Heaven by Bruno Mars. Fairly straightforward tutorial. There is only three or four basic sections you need to pick up and then just piece them together and you can play through the entire song. Perfectly fine for a beginner to start getting his fingers around. Reminds me, when I started out, I learned a lot of Police tunes, and the feel of this going from kind of an offbeat reggae style feel to then a driving eighth note rock very much reminds me in many ways of Message in a Bottle, which was a song that I played a lot when I was younger and have gigged a gazillion times. Before we go and look at that offbeat riff that starts out Locked Out of Heaven, if you're not subscribed to my free monthly e-zine, click the link underneath the video and head over, free bass lessons, and sign up. In return for entrusting me with your email address, you'll get a sequence of song tutorials in video and PDF format over the next few days. Locations will be delivered via email. And then every month there's a song tutorial, again, video and PDF format. All this material is exclusive to people who sign up. And as I say, it's free, just costs your email address. So go do that, and then we'll get started with the tutorial and we'll look at that offbeat riff. Just heard the basic verse pattern being played for Locked Out of Heaven. I'm going to show you two ways to play it. Go through the notes and one way to play it, and then we'll look at a slightly different way of playing it. Whichever way you choose depend on your fretting hand system, size of your hand, size of your bass, all that kind of stuff. But armed with both options, you can make the choice. So starts on C to D, those first two stabs. C and D, third and fifth frets of the A string. Then you've got a hammer from C to D and back to C. Again, third and fifth frets of the A string. Then you're down to A and B flat, fifth and sixth fret of the E string. That's the kind of pattern. And then you've got the next pattern, another offbeat pattern. You're going to play A, B flat, A, fifth, sixth frets of the E string again, F, the first fret of the E string, and then to G at the third fret. So that pattern, and then there's some more on the G which we'll do as well. That pattern you'll get. And then you're back into the offbeat pattern C and the D, which are on the and of beat 3 and beat 4. That's one way of playing it. I'll play it slowly. Okay, then another way of playing it, you can play it like this. So it starts on C and D, again, obviously all the notes are going to be the same, the note locations are the same. You've got C, the hammer on to D, back to C, again, third and fifth frets of the A string, the same. This time, play the open A string and B flat at the first fret of the A string. So that would give you this pattern. And then the next pattern, you play A, B flat, A on the A string again, and then F, G. So you'd get. So that's an alternate way you can play, which might be slightly easier if you're a beginner. Personally, if I was teaching you and you're a beginner, I'd try and get you to play the other way, because you'll use more of your fingers, you'll keep your hand spacing, you'll need to keep your hand spacing open because you'll need to cover C to B flat, and you'll have to get that shift down there and try and get that nice and smooth. I think from a learning point of view, it's that way is a better way for you to play. But if you need to play it for a gig or playing with your mates, play whichever way is easiest. Either way does the job. Do whichever way suits you. So that's the pattern we use for the intro and the verse. Let's go and look at the next section, which is kind of the pre-chorus, as we're switching from this kind of riff to the chorus feel, which is much more eighth note and much more kind of driving, rocky feel. Okay, the pre-chorus is an 8-bar section. Half of it is based on the riff that we learnt in the verse in the intro, although we don't end that 4-bar section with the C and the D, as you probably heard. And then half is a kind of the transition from that offbeat riff pattern towards the rockier style of the chorus. So if we go through it, we pick it up from there. That's what we've learnt so far. And then instead of playing, we're not going back to the riff, so we're just going to play two more G's on the third fret of the E string. That takes us then to bar 5 of the pre-chorus, which is F at the first fret of the E string, and you're going to just play a simple pattern, which is 2 eighth notes and a quarter note. Then you're going to go up to the 5th fret of the E string to A, and you're going to play this kind of pattern. And then that sets up the chorus. And what you're playing there is 2 A's, 5th fret of the E string, G, octave A, 5th and 7th frets of the D string, and just playing that in an 8th note pattern. 8th note rhythm, rather. Just play that, and then we're down to B flat, which is the first note of the chorus, which is the next section we're going to go look at. Okay, the chorus, 16 bar section, very straightforward. It's got 4 notes, it's got B flat, we've got G, B flat the first fret of the A string, G at the third fret of the E string, F the first fret of the E string, C the third fret of the A string, and it plays 2 bars of each of those in just straight eighth notes. So it starts off on B flat to G, F, back to C, then it repeats that, so B flat to G to F to C, and notice there at the end of that C bar you've got to get the transition back to the riff in. So in the last bar of C, play 6 C's, have a rest, and then hit the D. And then you'll be back smoothly into the riff pattern, which makes up, there's like an interlude between the chorus and verse 2, and then you'll be into verse 2, which you use this pattern for, even though the drums change, everything kind of drops out the first 2 times through the riff pattern in verse 2, and then everything picks back up. Then we go to pre-chorus again after verse 2, then chorus 2, there's a double chorus, there is a stab, or a stop, however you want to think of it, on bar 16, the first time through when you play the chorus twice together, and then if you listen to the original you'll pick that up, and then we go to a little breakdown-y kind of section, which is the chorus chords but a different rhythm, very simple. I'll just go and quickly talk about that.
Thank you.
after the double chorus, chorus two, chorus three, there's like a breakdown, chorus chords again, but what we're going to do is just going to hold the notes for two bars. So same sequence, B flat, G, F, C, and repeats that. So B flat, G, and these locations are the same as when we did the chorus, down to F, and to C. And then you'd be into the riff again, and you just play through the riff twice as the outro, and it... and it would just finish the second time through on that C and the D. So, pretty straightforward song, this one. A pretty easy tutorial. Pretty easy to learn. Put the parts together, cross-reference with the original. You'll be able to play along with the original and get through the song. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. I'll catch you next week with the next tutorial.